Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, what to do when audio stops when the slide changes. Hi and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've ever had a problem where you've got a pre-service slideshow loop and you're playing background music and then it changes slides and all of a sudden it gets quiet, go ahead, like, subscribe, and do all that other fun stuff. So, as it turns out, I thought that I had made this tutorial before, and I kind of did. When this feature was added, I made a tutorial for it, but you might have forgotten about it, or it got lost in all the other features, and so I didn't highlight it. And so more than once, I've had to correct people that were running on old information in the ProPresenter users community that I run along with Renewed Vision on Facebook. It's not that the information was completely wrong, it was just outdated. Renewed Vision addressed this, so I thought that we would go into the computer and I'd show you exactly what they did to fix this problem. So here we are in ProPresenter, and if we go to ProPresenter and then either settings, if you're on either of the last two versions of macOS, Sonoma or Mojave, or preferences if you're on anything else, including Windows. So go there, and then let's go down to advanced.
Hey there, aspiring ProPresenter Pro. Are you tired of getting tangled up in tech trouble? Want to impress your congregation with mind-blowing visuals? Well, look no further. Introducing ProPresenter 7 training at Church Tech U, your secret weapon for unlocking ProPresenter's full potential. Join me as I dive into the world of captivating presentations, smooth transitions, and jaw-dropping effects. From beginner basics to advanced tips and tricks, I've got you covered. Don't miss out on this amazing opportunity. Visit churchtechu.com/free trial for a free month now. Did I mention it's free? And revolutionize your ProPresenter game. Your congregation will thank you.
So this is the screen that where we want to get to, and it's right in here, and it does require a little explanation so that you know what happens in what circumstances. So, first off, we've got foreground media behavior is the heading that it's on. The way that it used to be is if you had foreground media, even if it was a still image on a slide, then the audio would just stop. Which, if it was a foreground video with audio, that makes sense. But if it was just a still image, it didn't necessarily make sense. And so that was what was confusing to a lot of people. I put out a hack earlier to get around this problem a couple of years ago. And I said, don't put the media on the as a background piece of media, because that could cause another problem in that you go to another presentation that doesn't have media, or you skip the background, whatever, then you still have the last slide on, so that's no good. Instead, what I was telling people to do was to put the media on the slides layer itself, and that did solve the problem. But Renewed Vision went above and beyond, and they added a couple of features here that are gonna just make it better. So, first off, we have the ability to change it for either the slides slash presentation layer or the announcements layer. So, each of those could be different. If you're using the announcement layer for your pre-service slide loop, it could be that you want to have it set to a certain way, and then on the regular presentation layer, you set it a different way. So let's take a look at the choices. They're the same amongst both of those, but I did want to start there. So let's click on this drop down and just go through these five different choices. The audio layer ignores foreground media. So what that says is, even if it's a video with audio, if it's foreground, the audio layer just ignores it, like it's not there. Maybe you never do a video with audio, so that's perfect for you. But if you do, or you might want one of the other choices. Next, audio layer is cleared for all media. So what that does is it, using the, so let's go down here, lower right hand corner, to this. So if we are looking at this, notice that we've got an audio transition here. And right now I've got mine set to 1.7 seconds. It can go up to 10 seconds or down to 0 seconds or anything in between with decimal places there. So let's say that I wanted to set that to 1.6 seconds. Not only does it crossfade between audio tracks here, but it also, when it clears, so if I had it playing and I hit the clear button there, it would take 1.6 seconds for it to clear. So that would be like a subtle change where the audio would slowly come down as you're bringing in the foreground video. So a lot of people really like that. Audio layer is cleared if media has audio. That's great. So another possibility here is audio layer is cleared for all media. I kind of skipped over that just a second ago, but it's saying I don't care whether it's a background or foreground, whether it has audio or doesn't have audio, it's cleared either way. Remember, just clearing it all together using that audio transition. Next, audio layer pauses, resumes for all media. In this case, pause is an instantaneous thing, so it would just stop it, which you may not want, but the advantage of this is that when the media is over, it will resume. And then the bottom one here, audio layer pauses, resumes if media has audio. So the two that I tend to like personally are the bottom one and the middle one. Middle one is, hey, it just fades down and then the foreground media plays, or it pauses, foreground media plays, and then it resumes at the next opportunity. So those are the two. I really kind of wish there was a hybrid of the two where the audio would fade down, you would play it, and then it would pick back up right where it left off. Probably the closest thing that you can do is on the slide following the media, you could put the song that you want it to start up with. Won't start back up in the middle of the song, but it would start up in that song or the playlist, etc. So those two are the ones that you're probably going to do. And as I say, the announcements layers has the exact same choices here. So you can do different stuff between those two layers. But that is the correct way, the feature that was added in ProPresenter 7.5, if memory serves, to deal with the problem if the audio just goes away inexplicably when slides change. It's not inexplicable, it's on purpose, but this is what you can do to fix that. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to TDM.fyi/pro7 and quick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.